Good morning, friends. I am Rajan Prasad, and at present you are viewing my channel Raj Photo Tech. In this episode, we will learn how to replace Sky with Blend If command. Blend If is actually an underrated tool in Photoshop. It is hidden in the layer style, and it is not normally mentioned by the photographers. This is because most of them don't know it exists. Actually, it is the easiest way of blending in Photoshop. Much like blending modes, Blend If allows you to blend layers together, but with much more control. And I guarantee that once you learn it, you are going to use it frequently. Understanding how any tool works is most important thing. So let us first understand how this tool works. In one sentence, you can say that Blend If slider just controls the visibility of a layer. To understand how Blend If works, let us take an example. I have already opened an image in the screen. This image has two layers, as you can see in the layer panel. At the top of layer, you can see many rectangles of different colors and a black and white circular gradient. And below this layer, there is a black and white gradient layer. Double click on the top layer to open the blending option dialog box. At the bottom, you will find the Blend If option. Here you will find two sliders, this layer and underlying layer. Top sliders, which is known as this layer, takes the information from the top layer, and the underlying layer takes information from the bottom layer. And Blend If basically makes certain areas of your image visible or invisible depending upon which slider you are using. First, we will look at the top slider known as this layer. I am dragging the left slider to the right, and you will see that the black areas of upper gradient are gradually becoming invisible or transparent. Actually, any tone on this layer, which is to the left of the slider, becomes transparent. And now I am dragging the right slider to the left, and you can see that the white areas of the gradients are gradually becoming transparent. So basically, where you put the sliders determines what part of your layer will become visible or invisible on this layer. You will also notice that the edge of the blend is harsh, but you can feather it to make it soft. Any slider in the Blend If is made of two sliders. And remember, you can separate them by pressing the Alt key and clicking on the slider. Alt click on the slider to split it, and now you can drag the sliders apart to smoothen the edges, as I am showing you here, and this you can do with any slider. You have also the option of choosing the color channels. By default, it is gray. Now I am choosing the red channel. And you can see that when I take the right slider to the left, the red and white disappears. Similarly, when I choose the green channel, green and white disappear. In the same way, when I choose the blue channel, the blue and white disappear when I take the right slider to the left. So not only the light and dark, the red, blue and green channels can be used to determine which portion of the upper layer is going to be invisible or transparent. Now let us see how the bottom slider works. When you drag the left slider of the underlying layer to the right, black of the underlying layer becomes visible according to its tonal value, as you are seeing on the screen. Similarly, when you take the right slider to the left, the white areas of the underlying layer becomes visible according to its tonal value. We saw here how Blend If works. Now let us see how we can use it in real world. Not all images have picture a perfect sky. Here I will show you how to use the Blend If tool
in Photoshop to replace a sky quickly and easily. It can be used to replace a sky in an image by effectively making the selection for you so that you don't have to do it manually. This alone can save hours of work, especially when we have some very detailed tree branches in the workaround. To replace the sky, first open the image. I have already opened an image of the house here, and you can see that the sky is flat white. If the layer panel is not open, open it by pressing F7. Now duplicate the background layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. And in the layer panel, you can see that the image is duplicated. Now open an image of the sky. I am opening a saved sky image here. Use Ctrl A shortcut to select the entire cloud image and then press Ctrl plus C to copy it. And then click on the background layer of landscape, and to paste the cloud over it, press Ctrl plus V. Double click the top layer in the layers panel to bring out the layer style panel. You can find the blend if menu at the bottom of the layer style panel. Make sure that the blend if settings is gray, because the sky which has to be replaced is almost gray, and drag the rightmost slider of this layer gradient to the left. As you can see, this makes the blown out sky in the house image transparent, and through it you can see the sky image which is below the house layer. To make the blend more subtle, split the sliders into two by holding the Alt key and clicking on the slider. Once the slider is split, drag the two halves away to get a good transition between the old sky and the new, then click OK. Let us see which areas of the image the blend if slider has made transparent. For this, click on the eye icon of all underlying layers to make them invisible. Now you can see the transparent areas of the image. Photoshop shows the transparent areas as checkerboard pattern. You will notice that some areas of the house and grass have also become transparent because their tonal values was similar to the sky. To see these areas clearly, we will place a solid color adjustment layer beneath the house layer. Click on the cloud layer to select it and open the adjustment layer panel by clicking its icon at the bottom of layer panel, and then click to select solid color. Choose red color in the color picker and then click OK. Now you can see all the transparent area clearly. You can easily see that the corner of house roof, its window, and some light areas of the grass have also become transparent. The solid color layer was only to see the transparent areas. So click now on its eye icon and it will become invisible. Now click on the eye icon of underlying layers to make them visible again. To regain the transparent area, click on the sky layer in the layer menu to select it and then add a layer mask to the sky layer by clicking on Add Layer Mask icon at the bottom. Now take black in the foreground color. Take a brush and paint on those areas which you want to retain. And you have successfully changed the sky in minutes. Hope you like this tutorial. Kindly like and subscribe my channel for getting more tutorials like this. Bye for now. Meet you again in the next tutorial. Have a nice day. I hope you enjoyed our tutorial. Kindly subscribe and like our video channel for more interesting video tutorials. If you want to get notification about our upcoming tutorials, kindly press the bell icon. See you again in the next tutorial. Goodbye and have a nice day.